All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm back at this New Yorker three-zone gas-fired boiler, done wrong, with this Techtanium indirect fire water heater. Customer's complaint, as documented on the last service call, they have to continuously, every year, bleed out this zone. Yep, folks, we're missing a vital component here called an automatic water feed. No, called an automatic water feed. I just left the steam boiler where there's a hole in it, and the automatic water feed fed the boiler until it cut a hole above the water line. But no, we're missing an air scoop, air separator. So we're gonna play with this a little bit and have some fun. You guys ready? Let's go. All right, I already got the power turned off. Close boiler feed valve. Second floor, first floor, indirect. First floor, second floor, indirect. This hose is a little annoying, but it's not in the way. Let's get a bucket and drain down. All right, the game plan here is I'm gonna cut a piece of threaded rod with a split ring hanger here and a ceiling plate to hold this up. And I'm gonna cut probably here, and I'm gonna cut there. I'm gonna take this 90 out, I'm gonna take this out. I'm gonna put 1.25 inch press male adapter in there, male adapter in there. I'm gonna come out a little bit, put my press air separator here, and then come up and tie into there to help get the air out here a little more quicker. Took out my automatic air valve. The top of the boiler right there. And next, we're gonna remove the expansion tank and put it off to the side for later reinstallation. Let's close that off. Should be fine. There you go. Off to the side. So the majority of the water and pressure has been drained out for the boiler. Let me cut a piece of threaded rod for here. Hold this up. Even though things may work in my favor, I'm still gonna be a professional and properly support that. Excellent. All right, let's start cutting. See? Perfect. Perfect. Now I'm going to separate the union on the backflow. I can take this out and cut out that zip tie. May get a little bit of water here. Just a little bit. Okay. Let's take this out. We're going to reuse the pressure reducing valve and the backflow. I'm going to tackle the hardest part next. Let's get my wrench in here. Hold back on the fitting while I try to take out that cut piece of nipple going into that fitting. All right, let's see if I had my Wheaties this morning. Easy peasy, huh? Easy peasy. Get out. Come on.
loose. I don't need to hold back. Don't you hate it when they loosen up for you? All right. Now, next. Well, thanks for not soldering that in, folks. I'm not really working with a bunch of leverage here, but let's see what happens. Oh, perfect. Hello, Carlos. Remember this job?
Yeah, when we were here like 2 weeks ago, week and a half.
Correct. All right, I'm putting in an 1¼-inch Viga press by mail adapter into my supply header for the three zones. I still haven't figured out how I'm going to do this, but I'll probably come out a little bit here with some copper, my spiral vent, below that the expansion tank, boiler feed, pressure reducing valve. What's this called?
Pressure reducing.
What does it do?
Reduces the pressure.
From?
The main to the boiler.
What's the boiler pressure at?
12.
And what happens that when it goes higher?
It blows out of the relief valve.
Correct. At what PSI? On a regular steam on a regular hot water boiler?
30.
Okay.
And 50 net steam.
And then when you have one of those, it absorbs the pressure because it's a closed system, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Let's just size this up, see where this is going to go. You know what? It'll be about right there. So about yay long of pipe. Perfect. Didn't think I had enough battery. Not sure enough it did. Oh,
appreciate it.
Thank you.
Yeah. Put it by the freezer.
Okay, good.
All right. I could have put a 90 here and not beeline it into the T, but that's how I did it. So the boiler isolation valve is right now closed. I have a piece of brass, 1/2-inch nipple, check valve, another brass nipple, pressure reducing valve, nipple,
elbow, nipple, T expansion tank. So now, as replenished fresh oxygenated water enters the system, it's going to pass through the air separator. This one I'm using by Webstone. 1.25 press. What's great about using an air separator versus an air scoop, if I use an air scoop, I need to maintain 16 inches of piping to the left and right hand side of that air scoop before I have a turn. I could put a street elbow in here and it wouldn't make a difference. Okay. Carlos also worked on that while I was working on this. And let's open up the boiler isolation valve, adding pressure to this boiler. Make sure I'm not on fast fill, which I'm not. Perfect. We're going to add pressure to this boiler. Everything is pressed in. Doing its job already. Look at that. Awesome.